Friends, good morning. In last class, we have discussed about the Raoult's law for non-volatile solute and Raoult's law for volatile solute. Okay, but today we are going to learn about the ideal solution and non-ideal solution. Okay, the ideal solution and non-ideal solution can be explained from a binary solution. The binary solution is that if two mixable volatile components are called addition, then we have an ideal solution and non-ideal solution. We explain it very well. Okay. Then what is ideal solution? What is ideal solution? Ideal solution can be explained, it can be defined as the solution which obey Raoult's law, which obey Raoult's law. The solution which obey the Raoult's law under all conditions of temperature and concentration then it is called the ideal solution. Okay, the ideal solution can be defined as the solution which obey the Raoult's law under all conditions of temperature and concentration, then it is called Raoult's law. Then what are the objectives of ideal solution? The solution can be told or can be said the ideal solution which have the solution which have no volume change during the intermixing of components जेतो लामे दीटा component को add करिबा okay से दीटा volatile solute जेतो add करिबा जेते बेले किछि volume रे changes हे न थाए suppose तार किछि volume रे जदि changes किछि न हे थाए कि जदि हबन changes हबनि ताहाले ताको आमे कोगे बेटा कोले ideal solution कहि परिबा okay del v mix equal to 0 means there is no volume change while intermixing of two components and the solution which have no enthalpy change during intermixing of the components. When we intermix the components, two components, there should not be the enthalpy change. Enthalpy changes of only, it means there is no formation of heat take place. Okay, so there is heat formation that is not way, but it evolve of an enthalpy. किसी एब्जॉर्प्शन और एवोक्शन जब न हुए ताहले हम तक गोटे आइडियल सॉल्यूशन कहिबा सो इट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज डेल एच मिक्स इक्वल टू 0 डेल एच मिक्स इक्वल टू 0 व्हेन वी मिक्स द टू कंपोनेंट्स द एंथाल्पी ऑफ दिस मिक्सचर विल बी 0 ओके सो द सॉल्यूशन व्हिच हैव नो एंथाल्पी चेंज ड्यूरिंग द इंटरमिक्सिंग ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स एंड अनदर पॉइंट दैट इज and they the components should obey the they should obey obey Raoult's law they should obey Raoult's law they should obey the Raoult's law so the statement can be PA equal to P0A XA and PP equal to P0B XB It means the component, the vapor pressure of the component is equal to the product of mole fraction of the solvent and the vapor pressure of the liquid A. And the component, the vapor pressure of B is equal to the product of the mole fraction of the component B and the vapor pressure of the liquid B. Okay, this can be explained the ideal solution. Okay, tar abar example naba. Example, suppose 100 ml of benzene, 100 ml of benzene is mixed with 100 ml of toluene, 100 ml of toluene, then the volume of the solution will be, the volume of the solution will be 200 ml. The volume of the solution will be 200 ml. It means there is no volume change during intermixing of benzene and toluene. Jetebele ame benzene and toluene ko gote mixture banaiba, benzene and toluene ko gote mixture banaiba, ba e dita component jale addition kariba, gote solution tiyari kariba, ताहले से सॉल्यूशन रो वॉल्यूम रे किछि चेंजेस आसे नाही. 100 ml लेले 100 ml ऑफ बेंजीन 100 ml ऑफ टोल्यूम इट इज 200 ml ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन. द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन विल बी 200 ml एंड देयर आल्सो बी नो चेंज एंड देयर आल्सो बी नो चेंज और देयर इज नो एब्जॉर्प्शन और evolution of heat during the reaction. It means there is no enthalpy change. There is no enthalpy change. So we can write del V mix here, del V mix equal to 0 or del H mix equal to 0. Change in volume during the mixture equal to 0 and change in enthalpy of the mixture equal to 0. Means there is no volume or enthalpy change during the reaction, during the intermixing of two components. Next, non-ideal solution. Non-ideal solution kona? Non-ideal solution means the solution which do not obey the Raoult's law. Okay. Non-ideal solution. The solution do not obey the Raoult's law. The solution do not obey the Raoult's law, and it is called the ideal solution. Non-ideal solution. Ideal solution में हम देखिएगा, जे there is the intermolecular force of attraction between the components. Suppose हमारा A और B component निहाई थिला, A B निहाई थिला, से माना जो तेरे जो intermolecular force, molecular interaction बोल कर तेरीगा, intermolecular force और molecular interactions are the same as the molecular in molecular interaction between the A and B and D. Okay, in ideal solution, the molecular interactions are same as the individual interactions of the particles. Okay, but here non-ideal solution recommend with the molecular interactions are different. The molecular interactions, suppose I am a data component nature, semana with the intermolecular force achi, intermolecular, the components intermolecular force are differ from the pure solution or pure solvent. Okay, the solution which do not obey the Raoult's law, then it is called the ideal solution. So it have a answer to the PA not equal to P0A XA or PB not equal to P0B XB. It means the vapor pressure of the component A not equal to the product of the mole fraction of the component A and the component vapor pressure of the liquid A. Okay, here also we can say the vapor pressure of the product, vapor pressure of B is not equal to the product of mole fraction of the component B and the pure liquid and the liquid B. Okay. The solution will do not obey the Rolle's law. It means there is no volume also, volume rate or volume rate changes as well, enthalpy of the changes as well. It means I am mentioning the period right here, del V mix, when we mix the two components, the third component or addition period, the volume rate changes as it has. We can write not equal to zero, or for the enthalpy formation, इसे जितने रंगीला कंपोनेंट एडिशन करेगा ताले इसमें किसी एंथाल्पी का जो चीज़ एब्जॉर्प्शन और एवोप्शन ऑफ एंथाल्पी विल बी टेक प्लेस. ओके देन सो इट इज कॉल्ड द नॉन आइडियल सॉल्यूशन. ओके इट इज जस्ट अपोजिट ऑफ द आइडियल सॉल्यूशन. आइडियल सॉल्यूशन और जस्ट अपोजिट नॉन आइडियल सॉल्यूशन. ओके नेक्स्ट देखिएगा और एग्जांपल होगा. Suppose some amount of H2SO4 is added or mixed with water, then the volume of the solution changes and there is some heat will be evolved. Okay, jetabale sulfuric acid seta water addition kariba setabale kon kichi volume changes asthae au ami dekhi parche kichi some amount of heat or amount of energy will be evolved during the intermixing of two components, that is sulfuric acid and water. Okay, so we can write del V mix not equal to zero, or we can say del X mix not equal to zero. Okay, this is the example of non-ideal solution. Okay, next we will move on to the topic colligative property of a solution. Okay, then what is colligative property? Colligative property of a solution. What is colligative property? Already I am telling you, when some amount of sugar is added to the water, then the property of the solution changes. Solution ra property kichi changes hasta. Okay, property kichi changes hasta. Like kahi changes hasta? Kahi kina due to the addition of some amount of sugar. Sugar means the solute particle and the water means the solvent particles. The addition of sugar, the addition of solute particle changes the properties of the solution. Okay, the solute particle changes the properties of the solution. Okay, the solute particles, particles means we can say the atoms, ions and molecules are the particles. Okay, solute particles can change the properties of the solution. It has been. So the colligative property can be defined as only upon the due to the presence of solute particles, the number of solute particles. Okay. So the colligative property can be defined as the property of a solution The property of a solution can be calculated the number of solute particles present in the solution, but not the nature of the solute particle. We cannot calculate or we cannot identify the nature of the solute particles. Only we can calculate the number of solute particles. How much of solute particles are present in the solution, and how it changes the properties of the solution. Okay. Next, the colligative properties can be explained in the four ways. Colligative property can be explained in the four ways. It can be explained in the. It can be explained in four ways. These are four types. One is relative lowering in vapor pressure, relative lowering in vapor pressure, and elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and the last osmotic pressure. Okay, the colligative property of a solution can be explained by four ways: relative lowering vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and osmotic pressure. We have already known about it, the relative lowering in vapor pressure. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the relative lowering vapor pressure. Relative lowering vapor pressure we dekhiba. Already ami all so relative lowering vapor pressure padhile dekhiba relative lowering in vapor pressure. Relative lowering in vapor pressure. We have already talked from the Raoult's law for the volatile solute and non-volatile solute, and for the relative lowering vapor pressure. From the Raoult's law, we know that the mole fraction of a solute, the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute, or you can say the mole fraction of the solute is equal to the relative lowering in vapor pressure. The relative lowering vapor pressure, RLVP, is equal to the mole fraction of the solute particle. Mole fraction of the solute particle. Okay. Already we have said the PS equal to P0XA. Okay, vapor pressure of the solution is equal to the product of mole fraction of the solvent and vapor pressure of the solvent. Okay, here we can write PS equal to vapor pressure VP of the solution, and P0 the vapor pressure of the solvent, and XA is the mole fraction of the solvent. Okay, by using this equation we can calculate or we can derive the relative lowering in vapor pressure. Okay,
already an answer px equal to p0xa. That implies ps by p0 equal to xa. Okay, or we can write 1 minus ps by p0, 1 minus xa. Okay, already I rods of formula bola time solution kar chule explain kar chule. That implies p0 minus ps divided by p0 equal to xb. Okay, and na already I am saying mole fraction bola bole xa cross xb equal to 1. Okay, the addition of the mole fraction of two components means the solvent particle and the mole fraction of solvent and the mole fraction of the solute particle is equal to 1. Okay, p0 minus ps divided by p0 equal to xb. Okay, if we have done earlier, the mole fraction, the relative lowering vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute particle. Okay, dekhi bhai p0 minus ps, p0 minus ps, these are called lowering in vapor pressure. Lowering in vapor pressure. P0 minus PS divided by P0 equal to relative lowering in vapor pressure. Relative lowering in vapor pressure. Okay, अब हमें explain कर बोले. XD equal to mole fraction of the solute. XD equal to mole fraction of the solute. So we can explain the relative lowering vapor pressure is equal to the Golgi property of relative lowering vapor pressure. Can explain the relative lowering vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute. Okay. So the Golgi property of relative lowering in vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute. Okay, आशा करते समझते बुझी पाती बो. हम next class में देखिबा the determination of molecular mass from the relative lowering vapor pressure and elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point and osmotic pressure. Okay, thank you.